What's up, Cubs? It's Kitsune Cat, and welcome to this post-recording, thing. I recorded this and I commentated it, but my microphone was unplugged during the commentary, so I have to now post-commentate it because the microphone was not picking up at all. So there was a sound door sound effect here. Oh, Skype, go away. So we're gonna face the first one, which is Livery. Skype, go away. Alright, so yeah, Lorelle? I don't know. So she sends out a Dugong with Surf, Hail, Safeguard, and Ice Beam. So that's the first Pokemon she sends out. Now this Dugong, I wasn't smart, I didn't start my Pokemon beforehand, so the first Pokemon that came out was Rizzadon. So I tried, because it's Ice, I tried to take out a Flamethrower. Didn't work out too well, but Rizzadon does then survive this Surf and doesn't go down in one hit, which is good. But I didn't plan in advance. I was also like looking up, trying to find a place where I could see the move list at the same time as playing this, because I didn't find one while I was off screen. But there goes Rizzadon. But yeah, I wasn't smart and I didn't get healing items. I had revives with me, but other than that, I didn't have any. So this is me also looking. So I have to then decide to go for Fudine, the Alakazam. And I thought Fudine would be a good idea, because if I think about it, the Psychic is quite a good sweeper for all types, especially in the league. You just need to be a little bit higher level. So this is, I think, what's the best thing to use really. So I tried Psychic, and because it was already low health, it died immediately. I don't know how effective it would have been without it, but I guess we'll never know. So 980 experience points, not a lot really. So yeah, and can I make this full screen? So she's on Slowbro, and Slowbro has Surf, Ice Beam, Yawn, and Amnesia. And if he gets off on too many Amnesias, I would not be in a good place at all. But it goes for the Surf, and the Surf doesn't take me out immediately. But it is a Psychic type, but it doesn't have any Psychic moves. So I think, what's the best thing for me to do right here? And I think maybe switching out would be good. So let's take back Alakazam, the Fudine, and send out Nidoking, because I didn't think, I needed Cannon Fodder, but it uses Surf and Surf is super effective as a ground type, but it survives. And I think, what can I use, because Electric is good against Water, but it's Water and Ice, so it's not the best effectiveness. But I'd go for the Shockwave, and it is super effective, but it doesn't kill it. But now it's paralyzed. Oh, it was paralyzed before, I did paralyze it. So then I try the Mega Horn, it takes them quite low, and it's still paralyzed and can't move. But so I tried the Shockwave just to take it out, and she uses first full restore out of three, I think it is. So the Shockwave hits, if it doesn't paralyze. Then I think, right, how can I do this? Still looking for that the move list. So I try the Mega Horn, see how well it does. Super effective, takes it down low, but then she uses an Ice Beam. And there was no way Nido King was surviving that, so it's gone. And it was super effective anyway, so there was no way in hell it was going to. So then I decided to go back to Fudine to see if I can get off an attack and kill it and get some easy XP, while also looking at still looking for those moves. I did find them eventually, this is where I got all the moves from. I will leave a link in the description because I have it bookmarked. So then I decide that I'm going to attack, and I'm going to try a Psychic, but again she's another full restore, that's two down. So the Psychic is not very effective, it takes down a little bit. I'm thinking, what else could I use? So I try a Psybeam to see if it will confuse it. Again, not very effective because it's Psychic against Psychic, and it uses Surf. Now, I just survived here, which is lucky. Quite lucky indeed. So I use another Psychic, not very effective. And then I go for the Ice Beam, which then takes me out. But it's now really low health, so I've got to pick someone to send out, and I go for Pidgeot. I'll go for the arrow. I think I'll go for the steel wing, but it's not very effective. So then use the ice beam, and it's going to be super effective against Pidgeot. Because of levels, it doesn't take out immediately, and then I spam A too quickly and try again, but miss. So then there goes Pidgeot because of the ice beam, I think. Yeah, the super effectiveness. So I'm down to two Pokemon, and I try Lapras. So Lapras goes for the attack, and goes for a surf. And just a quick and easy surf. Didn't think it'd use any more full restores, and it didn't, so that was lucky. So now Slowbro's down. So that's two down, and I'm down to two Pokemon left, and it's got three. So I think it's Lapras versus Lapras, and this Lapras knows. Surf, Ice Beam, Body Slam, and Confuse Ray. So I think, what's a good thing for a Lapras? A Toxic would be good, so I use the Toxic on it. And it'll slowly start whiffling down its health, even if I can't take it out. But because they're both Laprases and they're around similar levels, I can actually see the level from here. I can bring it up on my other monitor though. Right there, the Lapras is level 54, so it's lower level than me, which is good. So going for, it's kind of whittling each other down slowly. But it did have water absorb, sadly, so I couldn't get any, use any water types. I had to use ice type moves, which are not very effective. So it's going for the body slam each time, but this Toxic is slowly whittling it down quite nicely. But then she takes back her Lapras, and I think, what she thought of? She sends out a Jinx, and the Jinx knows Ice Punch, Double Slap, Lovely Kiss, and Attract. Lovely Kiss is Confuse type move. So then I go for the Toxic, and she switches back out again. So she must have been resetting the Toxic for the Badly Poison, so that it'd be back to normal. So then it's hit by poison again, it's just taking down a little bit, so I think Ice Beam. So I use the Ice Beam on it. And it's not very effective and takes down quite low. And then the Toxic doesn't kill it just, so the final Ice Beam takes it out. Oh, it doesn't. The Ice Beam doesn't take it out even, and it has to rely on the Toxic. Lapras by this point is quite low on my side. So then she sends out Cloyster, which knows Spikes, Protect, Hail, and Dive. So it can only really attack me with Dive, and that's not going to be super any effective at all, really. So I think I can use this to my advantage and heal up Lapras with my Max Potion, because I had some left over. And I could have saved it, but I did want to get past the first Elite Four member. So uses Dive, and the poison takes it out a little bit. So then I think, what can I use? And she takes back the Cloyster and sends out the Jinx again. So we already know Jinx's moves, but if you didn't know, if you can't remember, it's Ice Punch, Double Slap, Lovely Kiss, and Attract. And she does use Double Slap a fair bit. And it does some good damage. It's like four times every time, like that one. Well, I think one's a three time. But I do use Surf because it will slowly whistle it down. But I was worried about the Attract because they are opposite genders, I think. I did look at it and consider it, but it's fine. Managed to get off the Toxic, which really was, there was no point in hindsight. I just could have just used Surf and taken it out. But because of it, she does get off another Double Slap, and it's three times. But then the Surf takes it out, really. So in the long run, I should just use Surf, but I didn't. So so the Cloyster's back out, and it can only use Dive to hurt me, really. So it's just going to be continually diving. So on the turn, it's then underwater. I think I'm not going to waste a move. I'm just going to use Toxic because it'll miss. So then it uses Dive on me, takes down a little bit of my HP right here. When it does it, there we go. And then it's hit by poison. So then I get off the last attack and beat it. And this is her last Pokemon. So as soon as it goes down, she faints and she's lost. So then I was having a look, and I'm pretty sure I don't get any money for beating the Elite Four. You can't monopolize the Elite Four for money. So, waiting on myself to click the A button, I think I was then looking at Brawly, who was the next Elite Four member. So when it does it, come on, there we go. Things shouldn't be this way, but she didn't give me any money, which is annoying. So then I start reviving my Pokemon, and I use all my revives up. But I tried to revive it, and by using the, like, moving around with the buttons, and it wasn't working, so I have to use my mouse. So I slowly go through and revive all my Pokemon, and then he'll summon. I then look at the effectiveness chart that I had open, which shows me that psychic and flying are super effective against fighting types. So I decide to fully heal my Pidgeot and my Alakazam, because they would be the best, really. But then I think my Alakazam doesn't even see the light of the battle, because again, don't mess around with Pokemon. I go straight in for the fight in a second here without swapping around Pokemon at all. So I go straight in for the fight with Charizard first, but it's lucky because it knows a flying type move. So when it finally gets into the battle, there we go, the battle started. Bam, 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 bam. Music started, and there's Brawly, the muscle man he is. Well, no, Bruno. Why Brawly? Bruno. So you sent out a Onyx. I am worried because it is a rock type, and I missed the Onyx moves there. But he switches out immediately. But the Onyx moves are Earthquake, Roar, Rock Tomb, and Iron Tail, and the Hitmonchan is Sky Uppercut, Mach Punch, Rock Tomb, and Counter. But he does swap out to the fighting type, which means the fire type moves are going to then be super effective. So I'm just going to keep spamming the flying type move, Wing Attack, until he faints, because he uses up all his full restores on it. So then I realise here that my mic's not recording, because it's not plugged in. So I stopped recording after I figured it out and tried to re-record, and the mic still wasn't working because I had to clean close down my software, but I didn't realise that. So I'm then having a look here at the footage to see if it was working last time, just to check, and I realise it's not. So I then go, crap, so I will have to post commentate the first bit. And I think for this bit the mic's going to be on, so I'm going to guess I still can't commentate this bit. I'm like commentating as I'm checking, and I'm thinking, oh crap, so I'll just have to commentate the first half. But in editing, I realised that it didn't register my mic at all, and I had to try and fix it, because the microphone got come unplugged before I recorded. So then he sends out the matchup, which is Crush Chop, Bulk Up, Rock Tomb, and Scary Face. Scary Face. But he takes out the Rizzidon. So I think, what can I send out? It's a fighting type. So I send out Pidgeot. And I think Aerial Ace, because it's strong. It's going to be stronger than just the Wing Attack. So I use it, and it takes out immediately. So then I still got the EXP share on my Nidoking as well, because it was the last thing I was trading. So then the Hitmonlee has Mega Kick, Foresight, Brick Break, and Facade. Facade is when they got a status, but it doesn't matter, because it dies immediately. It goes down immediately. And then Pidgeot goes to level 55, and Nidoking gets some experience as well. So it sends out that first Onyx again, which had the Earthquake, Roar, Rock Team, and Iron Tail. I'm thinking, it's a rock type, it's not a finding type, so what's super effective against rock type? And I'm having a look, and I think I decide that steel would be better than flying, so I use a steel wing on it. And it's critical hit and super effective, so then that just takes it down to halfway, which I don't understand. If it's critical hit, then it should take it down a little bit more, but it does then use something super effective against me, and it makes my speed fall. I think it was Rock Tomb. But then I use it again, and takes out the rest of the HP. So, I get the experience, and he sends out the other Onyx, because he has two. So I use a Steel Wing against Onyx, has Double Edge, Earthquake, Iron Tail, and Sand Tomb, which is different to Rock Tomb. But the Steel Wing is still taken out very, very quickly, so it's down to the tiny bit, it uses Double Edge, and takes itself out. So there is Bruno down already. So Bruno is down, can't get any money from him, which is a sad, because that means I have to and my money outside of the Elite Four for my potions, my Hyper Potion to revives. So then I go around and do more reviving, because I only lost Rizzadon in this, really. So I'm having a look at something. I don't know what I'm looking at. It must be the next one, which is Agatha. She's Ghost and Poison. I'm thinking, who am I going to use in Ghost and Poison, really? Because I was on a look, and Psychic is a weak against Ghost, but super effective against Poison. So I have to I'm considering what to do, and also there's the flying type that they have. But yeah, so I do end up deciding that maybe Alakazam is better for it. So I do heal up Rizzadon, or my Charizard, and then I'm having another consideration and thinking Poison, what's good in Poison. And Psychic is the best thing against Poison in my team, I think. I think there's another thing I have, but I don't remember what's good. I think it's like Ground maybe? But they will have Levitate. So it makes that noise. And I face up against Agatha. Agatha, the old lady of Ghost and Poison. So I'm going in with Fudine first, which is my Alakazam. I did swap him around. I wasn't stupid. So for Elite Four, Alakazam sends out that first Gengar, which knows Shadow Punch, Confuse Ray, Toxic, and Double Team. And this one goes down fairly quickly, because it's quite a low level at level 54. It's about lower level than my Alakazam. But then she sends out her second Gengar, which is level 58. And this one knows Shadow Ball, Sludge Bomb, Synopsis, and Nightmare. And that Sludge Bomb was the bane of my team. It does take it out, uses the Shadow Ball to take out my Alakazam immediately. And then I try and use other things, and the Sludge Bomb is powerful, and I use Surf. I should, in hindsight, I should have risked the Hydro Pump to see if I could get off a stronger hit, but it didn't work, so he uses Sludge Bomb again, takes me out. But I think, try Dragon type with Surf. But I'm thinking maybe Water's good against it, and I use Surf. This isn't as strong, so it does take it down low, but it isn't as strong, so I try Ice Beam. She uses a full restore on it, taking it out full. No, I didn't try Surf. I thought I picked Ice Beam there. So use Surf, and it's a critical hit and takes it down to half. And I try the Ice Beam now. But she uses a Shadow Ball and takes down my Dragonair. So I'm thinking, what can I use next? I'll try Nidoking, because Earth is super effective. Oh, Ground. But I don't have any Ground type, so I just try the Bug type attacker, whatever it is, but he gets off the critical. So I think, right, Ground type, let's try Earthquake. Not realizing that it would have Levitate because of the Ghost. So I wasted my time and uses Sludge Bomb and kills me instantly. I could have taken it out there if I had not been stupid. So I think Flying was good with on my Flying type. Can't use a normal type attack. So really it's between Steel and Flying type. So either Steel Wing or Aerial Ace. I don't want to waste the time with the Fly. So I try the Steel Wing, but I didn't get it off in time. Wasn't fast enough. And there we go. Defeated by Agatha, sadly. So that was my attempt. And I read that message. Just something about a blind man walking into things. It's not funny. But I think, right, so I'm going to buy some items for next time, so while I have the money, so I buy some Hyper Potions. I can only afford two, because they're expensive, and I can't afford any revives afterwards. So I will be doing some training off screen. I do have a place I can train, but I can't face them again for half an hour after this. But it's been and gone, and that's that. So I'm gonna end it here. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next episode. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you again. Bye, Cubs.